How's it going, everyone? My name is Mike and welcome back to Plants vs Zombies 2. I am now going on to gameplay of Rose, one of the six new characters put into this game. So just like my previous video and all the rest that were coming up, this is post-commentary, just so I can give a little bit more of an insight and proper dialogue instead of getting distracted by the gameplay a bit more. So this is Rose. She, in my opinion, is probably not the best plant class. Like I said, my opinion, I just couldn't get on with her. I didn't know where to start. So I'll start with the bad. I'll start with how I tried to correct it, where the gameplay goes from there, and how I can see her being played. But I think it will take a lot of practice and a lot of luck. So first of all, I'm not sure where she's supposed to be on the map when I'm going to go in. I don't know if to attack or defend or stay at a distance and support. She has kind of the support class about her. The only thing that really does any damage she has in attack wise is her normal kind of this attack now with her little magic rose wand. Which actually doesn't do that much damage even to an imp who has like no health. It does like, I don't even know if that was hitting him. Or her enigma thing, which is set to Y. That does about 20 damage. You can get about 2 to 3 bursts off it depending on how fast you are. I think she's more of a support and a kind of screw everyone over so then all your other teammates can come in. The problem is, if your other teammates aren't around you, you don't really have much like any damage output kind of controls or powers, I mean, to maybe survive long enough. So I'll start with like her wand. Like I've said, it doesn't really do enough damage for me and it's only got 20 shots. I think she needs a little bit more health, but because she's like probably a small to medium character anyway, I think she's on like 125, they're not going to push her up anymore. Her first ability, the time shift type hourglass thing, that's quite good. It will, it's similar to Citroen's EMP. It will slow enemies down and confuse them slightly. So it gives you a chance to either do one or two things. Escape, because you have no damage output. Or you can try and get to an angle or around the enemy that you've caught in it to try and do some damage and kill them. That's pretty much it. I think it's one of those ones that, you again, people need to be around. You can trap people in it and let the more damage dealing enemies finish them off. So it kind of goes to the gameplay that you might be getting just more assists with Rose rather than actually going in heavy and trying to get the kills. Her enigma move set to Y, it's quite a good move actually. It's in the way that it gives you a little bit of a speed boost. It makes you a little bit harder to hit. So it's one of those ones you can use to kind of like use as a cloak to get away from like any danger. And like I said, it's got some burst that you press Y to use it, and then you press right trigger to do like a AOE kind of, I think it's an AOE, whatever it's called, an outburst of like pink powder. I don't think it puts any like effects on the enemies. Like, I don't think it dazes them or confuses or slows them down. I'm not too sure. But from the introduction that I'd done with her, it didn't look like it done it. It looked like they showed on the video that the people combined together and they exploded, which does not happen. It's just like a spread out kind of thing that explodes and hits anyone within its radius. Next up, we've got the goat. So there's a couple of things you need to know about this. First of all, it's really good to use if you need to get out of a sticky situation. It can hit more than one person. So as long as they're in the kind of the cloud burst radius of it, you can get multiple people turning into goats. So it's good for, one, you can use it and you can turn people into the goats and then you can attack them, which will lead, that one will lead on to point like three, I think. Two, it just means you can just do more damage to someone. You can also use it to escape. So do it and then you can run away. Going back to point one, where you can kind of defend or attack or anything like that with someone on the goat, you need to realise that anyone who does get turned into a goat will probably run, so that gives you a chance to get your attacks in. The off chance of that is the goat can attack. They are given actually 3 moves. Now, in none of my gameplays, near the end actually, it's either this one or the other plant, I've only ever been turned into a goat a couple of times, and then instantly I've died. But when you get turned into a goat, you do get three attacks. To my knowledge, I think one is a jump. The other one that I see a lot of people doing is they have a ram attack. So they can still hit you. So if they run away, it's because either they're nearly dead anyway, or they haven't noticed that they've got attacks. So you have to be wary that at any point that you turn someone into a goat, that actually they have, I think, at least the power of two attacks to hit you. So you could do it and think, yep, I've got the upper hand here, and then you just suddenly get rammed by the goat and you're dead. So just be wary of that, but it is quite good if you need to. I think they take more damage anyway, so it's good just to clear out the area. And I don't think you can turn robots or anything into them, but I don't hold me to that. So like that character there, that just back there that I killed, or the Z-Mech from the Imp. Just be careful, I don't think you can turn them into goats. But anyone that's close, turn them into the goat. They'll have a couple of seconds of transformation, and you can get some hits in that. And that, it will just confuse people for a second, and yep, you're good to go. Other than that, I just wasn't too sure what to do with her. I didn't like her as a character. I couldn't decide if she was offense or defense or support. I'm leaning more towards support, but this game doesn't really have that communication. Otherwise, it's just throw everything at someone and then hope for the best. I mean, attack-wise, you're on a one-on-one, you're probably not going to win unless you're really lucky or someone else is about to help with the attacks. So, like always, if you like this episode, hit the subscribe and like button, enjoy the rest of the gameplay, and I'll see you for the next one. Let's go.
Thank you. Cora,